What's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube. The Fabric launch has been amazing. There's so many new things and everybody's talking about lake houses and Python and Spark and data warehouses. But me, I'm falling in love with this one lake. How do they do it? A little like hard. One of the things that I've been thinking about a lot that I'm obsessing over is getting data into the one lake. And I have some ideas and some videos I'm gonna do, but I wanna start like really simple, really basic with this thing called the One Lake Explorer. Have you seen it? Have you used it? It's a quick and easy way to get data up. And so what I like to call it is the OneDrive for data. So you think about OneDrive, right? Upload, download. But imagine doing that with your data, Parquet files, CSV files, stuff like that. So wait, enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. To work with this One Lake Explorer, you need to go download it. And so if you just go to this document right here and scroll down just a little bit, you can download it. Click there and then walk through this, the standard download, okay? And you should probably read the documentation. I'm not reading it. It's like an unboxing that I'm doing here because I have so many things. I'm like a kid on Christmas morning, right? So once you get it downloaded and installed, if you go to your file explorer, right under OneDrive, you'll see your One Lake Explorer, okay? And we're gonna come back to this. Don't get too excited like me. Let me show you how this works. So what I'm gonna do is I've created a workspace here. I call it my Fabric Playground. So I'm gonna create a lake house. I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna create a lake house and I'm gonna call this guy in a cube. And create it. And then if we go back over here to the One Lake Explorer, I have some other things that I've been working on here. If I just right click on it and I say sync from One Lake, what is this eerily familiar to, right? Think about OneDrive. Sync OneDrive, sync One Lake. Let me show you. So I'm gonna say sync from One Lake. Give it a second here. Go to my playground and you can see Guy in a Cube. If Guy in a Cube doesn't appear, remember, just right click and choose sync from One Lake and it'll appear. Now, let's say someone sent me some data that I needed to analyze or work with. And I'm like, well, I wanna write queries against it. I wanna use it against Spark. What do you do? If you don't have any Spark clusters created or you don't have a local SQL server running, but you have Fabric in your environment, it's so easy to get that data uploaded and start working with it. Mark Walter sent me a JSON file. And he was, Patrick, how do we flatten this out? And that's a whole different video. But what I did was I just copied that JSON file and I pasted it into the file section. But maybe you go, Patrick, I want to create a folder. Yeah, do this, right? I'm going to create a folder, call it JSON, and then I'm going to move this file into that folder. But where's it going? Let me show you. If you come here, you click refresh, and then there's JSON, and then there's the file, right? I can go rename it. Let's rename this. More, click rename, and then we go back over to the file explorer. And then what I'm gonna do is go back to my Fabric Playground and go back to Guy in a Cube. Let's sync this up. Go to files, JSON, more orders. It syncs both ways. If I change something locally, well, if I change something on my machine, or if I change it up in Fabric. But that's not what blew my mind here. I gotta show you this. So what I did was, wait, stop talking, Patrick, back to your laptop. Let's go back to Fabric. And so I'm gonna switch over to a different workspace. I'm gonna go to Patrick's Fabric demo. And what I did in this demo, I created this lake house of the New York taxi data and I created a shortcut to it. I'm pointing to Azure Data Lake that's in a separate tenant. It's not in the Guy in a Cube tenant. And I created a shortcut to it, like creating a shortcut to a Word document or a file or something like that. That's the short on shortcuts. No pun intended, but Adam will give you more details. So after I created that shortcut, I was curious. I went back to my One Lake Explorer. I went to my Fabric demo. I went to the folders for that lake house. I went to files. Look, this is the shortcut, New York Taxi. I went to New York Taxi, and these are the files that's in the data lake in another tenant that I made a shortcut to. Adam's gonna blow your mind with shortcuts. Stay tuned. But this is an Azure Data Lake container that I'm accessing via my File Explorer. What I can do is if I just go into yellow, I'll choose 2010. I'm just, you know, navigating through this March, the third month in 2010. I'm going to take one of these files. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to head back to my Fabric Playground, go to my Guy in a Cube lake house, go to my files. I'm going to select new folder, ADLS Gen 2, and then I'm going to paste that file right in there. Boom. Now I'm going to head back to Fabric. Let's go back to Patrick's Playground. Go back to the Guy in a Cube lake house. I know what you're thinking. Look at that. ADLS Gen 2. I click it. There's the file. I can load this to Spark. I can load this to my table section without writing any code. We gotta give it a better name. We're gonna call this taxi cabs. I can choose load. There's my table. I can load this into a data frame in a notebook if I want to, but I write T-SQL. What I'm gonna do, this is the flexibility of Fabric. I'm gonna switch from the lake house to my SQL endpoint, because that's what I write. I write T-SQL. And now there's my table. Click the ellipsis, new SQL query, select top 100. How much code have I written? Very little code. And now I'm analyzing this data. I can write selects, group bys. I can do whatever I wanna do and make sure it's in the shape that I need it. All right, what do you think? Is this One Lake Explorer amazing? If you like it, you got any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about Fabric, there's a video flying over my head that Adam did that gives you a good overview of Fabric. As always, I'm Adam myself. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.